The design of these products is all about like a singular goal, and that's just make the best thing.
This is a product that's very near and dear to my heart. This is like my original, like, go find yourself Pete in the wilderness and on the road trip occurred in 2008. And one of the ideas I came up with was capture, the original mechanism. But another thing was I was looking at my tripod and it's this circle here and a circle here, a circle, like it's these four circles that don't play into each other at all. And they got a bunch of knobs everywhere. And the resultant product is like this really thick, you know, kind of wide diameter mechanism, almost all of which is negative space. As like one of the principal accessories, camera accessories for any photographer being the tripod, I've been obsessed with this idea of removing all that negative space for years. I was in Darjeeling, India, like sitting at this cafe, looking at my tripod, and I drew the sketch of a circle, and I drew a triangular center column in the middle of it, and then I just drew these like, almost like pie wedges. And everything just folds into each other beautifully. So that's the tripod that we dreamed about a long, long time ago, and that's the one that we've got today.
This thing is a product of engineering, first and foremost. In order to get everything to nest and to be as absolutely compact as possible, anything you see on this that looks like something that's beautiful or is like nested has been kind of fought for tooth and nail because there just isn't room for it, frankly. I think that's very, you know, evident in things like the, you know, how the ball head nests within the kind of clevises on these legs here. The ball head only adds about an inch above the tripod hub. And what that means is it also helps you with to increase the stiffness, the overall structural stiffness. So the ultimate stiffness of this tripod is very high in the compressed mode because the distance between your camera and the point where the legs meet. And then the controls, we've got these concentric rings, everything is concentric on the ball head, so it's all right here in just a single hand access point. You're not kind of switching around between different knobs. We've developed our own plate kind of securing mechanism that is unique to this tripod, and that basically allows you to tow in to the tripod, and that right there is stable. There's also a lock that really cinches everything down. It's kind of like a double cinch. We opted for cam levers on this versus the twist locks because you're able to get all four at once and you're able to get them all up and then cinch them down all at once. In the bottom, stowed in this little secret compartment here, is a universal smartphone mount. And that just clicks into the tripod like that. You lock it down and you've got your phone in there, like so, and you're shooting. We're really trying to be a absolute top tier premium product, but come in at sort of like a like mid, low mid price point range that is accessible to people who aren't just, you know, flush with cash, so.
I guess the fact that interest becomes gauged on it is kind of a knock-on effect of what Kickstarter is for us. It has just always served as this launch vehicle for our products. And yeah, it becomes this gauge mechanism because you'll clearly indicate how important they are to people based upon the number of backers that you get and the amount of money that comes in the door. In my mind, we have been a tripod company since like 2012. It's just that this is our first offering now in 2019.